His head was the shape of a shovel.
What?
Okay.
What?
Be careful what you say.
No,
to stop a dog going for you, you shove your finger up its arm.
Yeah. Hey guys.
Oh shit, flaps. Sorry.
Careful, Mish.
You're not allowed to swear in the
you
first
know the
3 minutes of the video.
In there.
If they start making any noise,
they're
getting squashed.
What we need to do instead of not swearing in the first 3 minutes is find swear words that won't get picked up by the filters.
Peacock.
Willy.
Bitch. Female dog.
Bum.
Bum
fart.
I got loads of bitches
titties.
At home.
Constable. that's the old thing, innit? Like, all right, constable.
We should learn some like cocky rhymes.
It doesn't work if you fuck the word up. All right, constable. Oh, well, let me do it again. Truncheon over the head.
Truncheon. Did I? Oh, I can't tell that story. Anyway, guys.
How are you all doing?
Welcome back to the best podcast on the internet.
You know
the
it.
Freeskins Podcast.
You know it, bitches.
The best podcast on the internet.
Just by
trying
far.
To channel my
what are you
macho
trying to,
man
what are you
there.
Trying to hype it up, man. This ain't a wrestling, man. Oh, shit.
Yeah, well, what you don't know about that is much.
You're going lower. You can tell they've always got a rough script. Yeah. It's not entirely like, just make it up as you go along. I'm sure you'll be fine. You're not good at this.
What I love about wrestling is like, it's all these like mid-30s guys that look like they're 50, and it's like... They're all just terrible actors, and it's just it's clearly it's like, okay, you gotta go in there, you gotta be so upset. I can't believe that...
You
Macho Man has done this to me.
I am really cross.
I am upset and angry.
I love how as well, like when they keep bringing him back, like when they're really old and they just say like ridiculous things and everyone's like, oh, don't ignore it. He's from a different time and he's getting old now. It's like, no, he's taking so many punches to the fucking head. He's mad.
His
that's
dome.
Why they all say like,
come here, kids.
Yeah, that's why they all say, oh. Chris Ben Dry. Because when the fool tastes nice, the fool take Chris Ben Dry.
Dude, my fucking arms are like your guy's thighs.
Oh yeah, Macaulay Culkin, Rat Boy, Mac from the season of Always Sunny when he
fat
was
Mac.
Fat. Fat Mac.
Yeah, Fat Mac.
Even though Fat Mac is skinnier than me.
Oh, fuck. Bro, that's true as
that's
well.
That's fucked, isn't
it? Yeah, but he's only Fat Mac because we saw him gain weight. If the season had started off with him like that from the
that's
very beginning...
That's one thing I wanted to ask you,
beard as well,
Lewis.
That hides.
Yeah,
I was thinking about this the other day. And when we first ever met, which I don't remember the first day date we ever met.
2013.
What did you think of me? Like, what was your...
Do you actually genuinely want to know?
Yeah.
Do you want to have a little gay bro moment?
Yeah, go on.
I thought you were really fucking cool and you wouldn't like me.
Were.
So lame.
Thought you were
yeah,
really
thought you
cool.
Were really cool. No, well,
did you actually?
I was a 16-year-old, you know, 15... fresh-faced 16-year-old,
yeah,
you know.
I was grooming you.
Here comes this fucking guy, like, yeah, I'm fucking... And he's eating shit, and he's doing flips and stuff, and I'm like, oh, that guy's cool. He's not going to be interested in anything I've got to fucking say.
That's still the same.
Still true, yeah?
Really?
Yeah.
Did not I thought of you?
Because I'm thinking now of the first time... I think the first time we actually met was... we filmed a load of videos in Where's My Challenge, didn't we, with fans... Do you remember that? We did the cheeseburger thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, all that shit. I think that was the first time I actually met you. Yeah, and I just thought...
That means thing. You would have been there.
No,
you weren't there for the absinthe.
He wasn't there.
I was there for...
I left
I was
at that
there
point.
For when people ate loads of cheeseburgers.
When you guys all started drinking, I left because I'd literally just turned 16 and I was going to go home and play FIFA or something.
You were there for the cheeseburgers?
Yeah, I was there.
You were there for the cheeseburgers? Then you guys...
I left as you were eating them.
Oh, okay. All right.
Because I remember having to watch the video, like, I don't know who won.
No one. Guys.
Yeah, I don't really remember. I remember the absinthe.
I had like five.
Yeah.
I'm not a big eater or anything. I just got that mindset where I just like, I can convince myself that I can get to the end.
Yeah.
And when you convince yourself that you get to the end, you get to a point where your body just stops you from going
any
further.
I physically can't do it. I've starved myself so much over the years. My stomach, as soon as I feel it stretch.
Why'd you starve yourself?
Because I'm anorexic. No, I'm not. No, I'm not.
Yeah, he's only bulimic.
Joke. I did used to make myself vomit a lot.
Yeah.
There you go.
Not as much as you. Yeah.
Matt was horrible. He'd throw up every night.
Yeah, kids, if you're thinking about puking into carrier bags and hanging them out your bedroom windows to lose weight, just, you know, I remember watching a documentary years ago about a girl who was bulimic and didn't want her parents finding out. And she just would vomit into a carrier bag out the window, like... I don't know why you wouldn't just
imagine
vomit
if
out
you're,
the window,
you're like one of the parents. You're out gardening and there's a fucking bag of sickness.
No, but surely they must see it. Like,
God dang it!
They better feel it's like the gun.
I've lived in the same house like most of my life. Every time I walk up the path, I will still assess the house all over. Do you know what I mean? I won't just look at the door. Like, I'll look all over the house, like in case there's something new.
There's a bag.
You must see a bag of puke hanging out your window. Anyway,
it'd be so obvious.
Fuck, we've gone off track. What I was saying is, if these are the sort of horrible thoughts, obviously no one should be going through. Seek help, but also learn that it doesn't work. Because when I met Matt, he was skinnier than Greg. And this man made a living off of making himself vomit. And
it's only because he was taller than he was skinnier. It was probably the same weight.
It doesn't work.
What was it? Like 2 years ago, I got to the stage where I was losing weight and it was rapid.
Yeah, you were.
I lost about 30 pounds and it's because we went out walking all the time. Now I can't.
See,
yeah, since you're cheating,
Matt will use this stupid little bitch as excuse, but the majority of weight loss is in diet, not in exercise.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, shut up.
That's what I learned from our YouTube video.
Must be true.
Must be true.
Now, going back to the carrier bag thing, I might have said this before. I definitely said it about a dog, where a dog should swallow a carrier bag, so when it poos, it's already got his poo in a bag.
Yeah,
that
you did
can
say
just
that.
Put straight your way.
If you're a new viewer, that's the kind of genius you can be expecting.
You know, like those sausages, the sausage links.
Wait, what?
It would be going for intestines as well, I suppose.
Yeah.
Wait, so you put a carrier bag up a dog's bum?
No, no, no,
no. No, you sicko. You feed it
you
the carrier.
You feed a carrier bag and then it poos out the, in the carrier bag already.
But around the carrier bag.
I wish that's how like the world worked. That was so good.
Around the carrier bag would be poo. So you still wouldn't want to touch it. You'd still just leave it in the street. Because you'd be like,
you'd
it's covered in
shit. You'd
have
to pick the bag up with a bag. This is the thing I was thinking of. Swallow a bag. Swallow like a carrier bag. And then, like, you eat loads of food. And then you pull it back out.
Oh, for fuck.
Do you think you
fucking hell.
I'm surprised no one's invented a device that, like, attaches to a dog.
That's a good way of being bulimic. Because then you don't get, like, the...
There's no good way of being bulimic.
You don't
bulimic.
Get, like, the GERD.
Seek help.
I'm sure there are ways. That was that Gandhi guy. He didn't eat
Gandhi
much.
Gandhi was not puking around.
Oh
the
yeah,
back
what
of
was
his heart.
What was his surname again?
Just not eat muchy.
Mahatma.
Mahatma.
No, his last name was Gandhi.
Mahatma.
Yeah, I know. I was tricking you, Greg. Oh,
okay.
Mahatma.
Oh, great. Yes. Should we get into what we're doing today, or should we just talk? Have you guys been up to much? Cyberpunk, E3 happened last
Reeves,
night.
Yeah.
You know The Witcher?
Been reading a lot of books as
you
well.
You know
recently.
CD Projekt from Paul Skeet?
Oh, was there Cyberpunk thing?
Is there Cyberpunk?
Oh, Keanu Reeves
my
is in
goodness.
It.
Keanu Reeves is in it.
Yeah, he's as a
Keanu character. Reeves is so fucking cool, man.
Yeah, mate. Keanu Reeves is like one of those guys, you're just like, he's so cool.
There's a
yeah.
bit.
Why is he so cool?
There's a bit where he's like, I don't know, I always butcher things. And he says something like, oh, this is going to be breathtaking. And someone goes, you're breathtaking. And he's like, no, you're breathtaking. It's something like that.
What?
E3, man.
No, it just shows how my breath... Why is it E3? There's been like 10 of them.
Yeah, it's about E...
Isn't it halfway through
eight,
E3 while we're recording this?
Does everyone just take free...
I had no idea it was even on. Years ago, I used to
tablets.
Watch that.
Apparently, Xbox is making, like, a new Xbox, but they didn't... They announced that they were making a new Xbox, but they didn't show anything about it. So it's just like...
Yeah, well,
we
you remember what...
Fuck.
I think maybe they're a bit scared after the Xbox One. Because you remember... I remember when I was...
More like the Xbox...
Dude, it did so bad compared to the PS4.
I've been playing it a lot recently, though. I've been playing the Xbox a lot. Only because my PlayStation's hooked up upstairs. And I'm
Your
like,
bro
I'm
upstairs. Got one.
Yeah, my brother got one for Christmas, but he like hasn't touched it. And the only game, no, I've got.
Do you like Red Stripe?
I'll have one in a minute.
No! Don't you dare take that away from me.
I was offering
a sip.
Oh, you weren't actually giving it to me.
Uncivilized.
Hello, my friends. Make sure you hit 100 likes on this video, and keep an eye out for me and Greg live streaming because we're going to do it more often on my channel.
Yes,
the one with 50,000 subs and 2,000 views.
All right, wrestler. Enough self-promotion. Let's carry on.
Okay, guys, today
you kind of look like the Undertaker's like sidekick, like if he had a Robin.
Yeah,
you know
it's
what
like,
I mean?
like
the Undertaker comes out. It's like the Undertaker and his pal, then you run out like that,
like fucking Paul Bearer,
like Robin with your hair dyed and your like little black vest on, like.
You gotta have
Dude, eyes. My arms look so big. If I go like that, it's
yeah,
like...
Yeah, but so does the rest of you, so it's
all
not...
It's all tub.
Whoever's editing this, I'll give you a really hard job. Can you just make Matt look like really skinny
hard fat.
Here?
Can you...
Hard fat.
Yeah, I'm like them
you
pikeys.
You ever get like a bit
That's
of
what
like,
your rapper name should be.
You ever get like
hard
a bit of steak
fat.
And the steak, the fat on it, is just not... It's not soft and plubby. It's solid.
That's because there's muscle underneath it.
Yeah, but it's just solid fat.
It's like muscle
That's
underneath
such a
fat
guy thing to say. I got plenty of muscle.
Well,
actually, muscle.
I'd just like to point out who banged out that really muscly looking guy and was my stature.
Why are you banging out dudes? That's weird.
Seen that?
Oh, old Andy Ruiz.
Yeah,
man. I got
He got a nice little gut on him.
I loved it when he won.
All the fat boys were like, "Shut! Fucking told you, didn't I?"
Yeah, won like a thousand. They win one fight.
I'll tell you what, though, to beat Anthony Joshua, him against a fucking world, man. He was killing it. Absolutely destroying it. So to be beat like that by someone that looked like that, it was a fucking big deal.
Maybe he got beat too many times.
I'd have had fucking Anthony Joshua. Oh, yeah, no, that was it. There was a thing that went round, actually, and I don't know if it was a made-up thing, but it's quite a touchy subject if it's not. So somebody said, like, Anthony Joshua's mum or dad were there backstage, and they said apparently before the fight he had a panic attack, and the manager was like, "If you're in this sort of state, you're not going out." And he was just like, "Well, it's 5 minutes before fight now. I've got to go out." But I don't know if that's just something like real hardcore Anthony Joshua fanboys made up. But if it's not,
it's hard to know.
It's hard to know.
I'll tell you one thing: panic attacks are funny.
The way I see it is, one win is meaningless. Unless if he gets to a point where he's beaten every single person constantly, that's fair enough.
But dude,
one win.
You should watch some of his knockouts, man.
One win, yeah, but heavyweight knockouts are always intense.
That is.
I've never watched a heavyweight knockout and been like, "Well, that little pussy punch." It's always just like, "Poof!" It's like heavyweight boxing is 10 times more interesting. The lightweights are always like,
yes.
The heavyweights are just like.
Yeah, but I can't. Yeah, I love the fact that he won because on my certain social medias, I've got certain people that are real yeehaw, and they're all everything on their Facebooks, Trump stickers and shit.
Love that shit. Yeah,
like they're all every day posting shit. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, he's gonna build the wall and it's gonna be great. And then he won, and I had loads of posts like, "Yeah, USA, USA," and it's like Andy Ruiz is Mexican. Hence the name Andy Ruiz.
We're building a wall, but he can come over.
Yeah,
that's
that
the whole thing, isn't it?
He's okay. That one, him there. Yeah, the one with the toes and the gloves.
The whole
he
idea
can come
of
through.
Building a tower wall is so stupid.
Have you got any other talented people?
Have people never heard of trebuchets?
Guys, whoever's editing, right now, I would like for you to put the topic thing in. Right now. Where did that smoke come from?
Sorry.
Have you guys ever seen the show Would I Lie to You?
I used to love that show.
Yeah, it's a good show.
I used to watch it all the time. Real good. Mm.
Okay. So can someone describe to the viewers who haven't seen it what it is?
I think it's a primarily British thing. They might have foreign versions of it. I don't know. But basically the concept is... What?
Go on.
What?
I was thinking some like German guys like...
I do not lie!
None of these are lies.
Yeah.
They're all like...
I once knocked out a baby goat, and you'd be like, yeah, that's true.
None of them are lying.
Obviously, that's standard. Yeah, I do not lie. I don't know why they're Russian all of a sudden.
Oh, I can think of like this burly German dude just knocking out a goat.
No, dude, you know,
he'd
be like,
we're
it'd be like possession, and he'd just pull out like a big stein, and he'd be like,
I just see him like,
okay,
like walking up like this big mountain in the German Alps, and he just sees this mountain goat. He's like, what are you looking at me like this? And he just knocks it out, and he just like goes limp and falls down the fucking mountain.
The shit you find funny is just stuff you make up in your head.
I know where that's his thought process is coming from. There's that video of that guy pulls the sheep's head out of a chain link fence, yeah. And then he just rolls that. Yeah.
Right. No, Would I Lie to You has nothing to do with that. Basically, Would I Lie to You, the premise of the show is that it's two teams and a host, and on each team, they basically compete to see who can get away with telling the most fibs about their own lives. So they would bring a card out that would said, you know, I once knocked out a baby goat. And the other team would have to sort of ask him questions and co-host him, and they would have to choose whether it was a truth or a lie, you know. I don't think we're going to do you reckon we should be allowed to question each other on our truths and lies?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think that's the whole point.
I think you're right. Yeah. I didn't think we were going to do that, but
it's then you can good. Catch out the lie, you know what I mean?
But you're not allowed to, like...
I think I've done all right.
You're only allowed a certain amount of questions? Because, like, if you're just going to interrogate someone for 5 minutes,
yeah, like
it's going to become obvious what the fucking lie is. Yeah. Right, okay. So we've all prepared a couple... I think we're doing two rounds, right? We all got two rounds. We made up... They're all in sort of categories, you know, like, mine are about my childhood and then weird shit I did growing up with my brother, or weird shit that my brother did that I found fucking funny. I'm kind of selling my brother down the river here a little bit.
Is that what you meant, or is that actually just feeling? Is that the banjo or the feeling? Cupping balls.
He's tickling.
Who is going first?
Right. Who wants to go first?
I don't mind going first.
Yeah, you want to go first? Okay, right.
I think he doesn't want to go first because he's going to look like a dickhead.
Okay, right, you're only allowed three questions, so it's not you get three questions and you get three questions.
What if I want four questions?
Well then, tough fucking shit, Greg.
I got tissues.
Okay.
Okay, right, are we ready for the first round?
Wait, no, it's three questions for each.
You can ask questions about anything you want. If you hear something that you know is a lie,
okay, right.
You ain't got to ask questions about it, have you? Right, right, okay. Which one, do you want to hear about my dopey little kid brother, or do you want to just hear about real embarrassing things that happened to me as a kid?
I don't mind.
Go on, just pop some out.
Okay, right. I'll do my childhood. Okay, so this is...
You haven't written like a fucking paragraph.
No.
Mine are like sentences.
That was a thing. Some of them are such specific memories that I was finding myself writing this whole story. Yeah,
the less specific, the easier it is
That was another thing as well. We had to really delve deep because when we were planning this, we're quite open people. So anything sort of interesting, embarrassing or funny that's ever happened to us, we've talked about. So I had to like really...
Not on podcast though, I want to point that out.
No, not necessarily.
There's some crazy stuff that's happened that we've never spoken about.
But I really struggle to remember it. But yeah, a lot of stuff that we've done, we can't really talk about. Maybe we were on like a live stream or something. Yeah.
No.
Okay, right. But this is... I recovered shit in my brain doing this that I suppressed. And I was like, oh, fucking hell. Right. First one. I once shit myself.
That's the one.
At a kid's theme park. I won't name which one, but it's quite a big theme park where we're from. I once shit myself
at
a kid's theme park.
That beer tastes like soap.
Soap?
Did you guys prank me with a soap?
Did you get pranked? I once shit myself at a kid's theme park and to this day have a photograph somewhere of me mid-shitting myself and smiling. Stood next to the roller coaster entrance.
Don't ask questions. Let's get them all out of the way.
I once pissed myself on top of a climbing frame and momentarily tried to convince the kid underneath me that it was raining.
That's good.
That's good. If that's a lie,
it's not true, but it's good.
I once shit. I forgot.
Dude, what is wrong with your fucking arms?
I'm talking like.
You need to sort out.
I'm talking like. Yeah, but two of these.
You need to sort out your digestive.
Oh, no, two of them are true, aren't they? No, yeah, fuck. Okay. I once.
No, you're supposed to say all three of them are true.
Oh, yeah, they're all true. I once shit in an empty box of Turkish Delight and had my friend open it with the promise of Turkish Delight.
See, that sounds true.
That no. That one's too bizarre.
You think?
Do you want me to
bizarre Turkish?
Do you want me to go for a more rapid fire? Turkish Delight.
Come to my bazaar.
Turkish, brilliant. Turkish Delight, brilliant. Love it.
Right, okay, I'll go through them real rapid fire quickly again, and then you can ask me about them. You get three questions, okay?
Dude, your thing's like a novel compared to mine. Carry on.
I once shit myself. No, it's only long because you kept interrupting me. Mm. I once shit myself at a kid's theme park, and to this day have a photograph of me mid-shit smiling, stood next to the roller coaster entrance.
Why are you smiling? Why are you smiling?
Because I was a little kid.
That's a question. You've just ruined it.
That's my question. I can make as many questions as I want, bitch.
I once pissed myself on top of a climbing frame and momentarily tried to convince the kid underneath me that it was raining. And I once shit in an empty box of Turkish Delight and had my friend open it with the promise of Turkish Delight.
See, what I know about Lewis is that he has big issues with pooping. So
at an early age, didn't it?
I think the two poops might be true and the pee one might be a lie.
Two poops, one pee.
One of these is not like the other.
One of these things not like the other.
I'm going with that.
This one's hard.
That's my guess, Matt.
What, guys, write in the comments right now.
Yeah, remember, if you're still a bit confused, two of these facts about me are true and one of them is a lie. You got to wean out the lie. When I first started writing these, actually, I got it round the wrong way. I might have been baked. And I wrote two lies and one truth, and I thought we had to weed out what the truth was. And I was having a whale of a time, because I was just making up shit, and then I was like, oh, fuck, no. It's two truths.
I'm going for the P one. I don't know.
I once pissed myself on top of a climbing frame and momentarily tried to convince the kid under me it was raining.
The way I see it is that you have this issue with pooping.
I think Greg's right.
Okay.
But we still haven't asked enough questions.
No, you can ask questions.
You can ask me questions about.
Did you say to the kid underneath you on the climbing frame, "Hey, buddy"?
No, I was really.
No. Yeah, that wasn't my question.
Oh,
hey, buddy, your first. You first D?
You first.
No. What did the rain? Kid look like?
That's three questions now.
Why is that important? What's that going to help you?
Because I want to know how accurate your memory is of it.
Dude, I was like fucking...
Yeah, describe
six,
him.
Six, seven. Just a, six, no, seven. Just a normal looking kid. Short haircut, big ears, freckles. Just a normal looking little kid.
Piss. That sounds
I think he was a couple years older than me though. I may have been like six, he may have been like seven or eight.
So you were trying to dominate him?
No, I did it by accident. Okay. I was really bursting for a piss, but I didn't want to go inside. I was having too much fun playing. I climbed up to the climbing frame, like, it'll be alright.
So two of these are about
and I let it go.
Bad bowel controls, which we definitely know that Lewis has.
I'll tell you what, right? Me and Lewis are quite open about our bowels and shit in our pants and stuff. You've never mentioned. Have you ever shit yourself?
I've never shat myself.
No, he said, didn't he? I think on like podcast 4, we talked about toilet troubles. And me and you, because when you were talking about shitting yourself in Asda, he said he'd never shit himself.
We have spoken about this before. I've pissed myself loads. I've pissed myself like 100 times, but I've never.
Don't worry, everyone. You're not missing any high quality content here. We have briefly brushed over about how we all shit ourselves once.
Don't worry, guys. Next week might be about the best things found up a human's bumhole.
I forgot we were going to do
that. Stick around for that.
Yes. Right. Which one's the lie? Fuck.
Piss.
Piss.
You're both wrong.
Can we guess the next one? It doesn't matter, but...
All right,
I think Turkish Delight is too far. I don't think you've done that.
Do I have to say something?
You've already lost, but you're having like a redemption guess.
Go on, whatever.
You're both wrong again. What? The lie is I once shit myself at a kid's theme park and to this day I have a photograph of me mid-shitting and smiling. That's the roller coaster.
See, I did think that. That's the lie. Smiling.
I did once piss myself on top of a climbing frame And I did once shit in an empty box of Turkish Delight and give it to a friend with the promise of Turkish Delight.
It's a horrible thing to do.
Turkish Delight.
I was like, I went through like, I don't know, man, I was a kid, man. That's why I'm like genuinely convinced I'm like autistic or I've got ADHD or something. Because when I was like a real young kid, I was really shy and timid and I was embarrassed of everything. And then I hit like 8 to 12 where I went fucking mental. You know, and I just did weird shit to freak people out.
Mate, I came out my mum's womb with glazed eyes, and I ain't fucking changed. Like they were there. I was apparently.
You are a bad person.
Yeah, that's a horrible.
I didn't
thing.
Give it to him with the promise of Turkish Delight. I basically went just, "Oi, bro, look at that," and he was like, "Oh!" And he was just like, I don't know, probably in the corner of my room, like, and I thought it was hilarious.
That actually reminded me. When I was younger, I used to do this thing called tricking, and people go to, like tricking gatherings and stuff. And
that was the original prompt. You just got tricking, bro.
At tricking gatherings, man, the stuff that used to go on was absolutely bizarre and brilliant. But anyway, there was this geezer, and he was from up north. And he goes, "I can't do northern accents, so I'm already a little bit drunk." So
tell me what he said.
He goes,
hey, pal, why don't you look in this cookie bag?"
How up north are we talking?
Hull.
"Hey, pal, have a look..." What was it again? A cookie bag.
"Have a look in this cookie bag."
"Hey, pal, have a look in this here cookie bag."
Something like that, yeah.
Whoa.
They fucking speak weird.
That's not how people from Hull speak. I was just doing something.
He didn't have a look. This guy didn't have a look. I wasn't there. Someone told me this happened. He didn't have a look. He just went in hand first.
Oh, no.
And he pulled it out of shit.
Oh, fuck. I've got a good story as well, but I don't know if we need to let somebody else have a go. My, I'll be quick.
You are never quick with stories.
I know. I'll try and be quick. My mum used to work, I've spoken about it before, you know, she used to work washing the old people and shit.
Yeah.
Days before they died.
Great.
And, she used to work in the hospital, Trooper. And there was obviously like people in there that were old and fucking crazy. And there was this woman in there, I can't for the life of me remember what her name was, let's just call her Gladys. And like whenever, she'd always have a box of Maltesers with her. And my mum swears to God this is true. All throughout my childhood, I got her to tell it to me all the time. I was like, "There's no way this is true, it's hilarious." It's obviously not, it's fucking gross. She'd always have a box of Maltesers with her, and when anybody came, she'd always offer you one. And when anybody came in, like, had new employees or something, they go, "Oh," and they go, "Don't take one of her. Don't take a Malteser." She used to fucking shit and roll it up into little balls and put it in the Malteser box.
Nah.
See, I don't believe it.
That's not real.
My mum don't lie about
stuff
like that.
I'm
going
to grill your mum when I see her.
You can ask my mum about it.
I mean, I normally spit roast her, but today I'll grill her.
I just love the thought of these new nurses, like, "Oh, a Malteser," and they're like, like, they've just come straight out of medical school, do you know what I mean? Like, "Oh, boy," and then they get into the hospital first hand, but they actually, "Don't take Gladys's Maltese, this is her shit." How upset would you be if that was your first day? You'd probably quit. You ended
How
up
do you
with
feel about that, Greg?
Some
You've
old lady
quite
shit
silent.
In her mouth.
I hate old people.
All right. All right, let's do yours then.
Yeah, go on, Greg. Have you done sort of categories like I did?
No.
No, you've just done completely random
too.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Okay. So this is the lame ones because I could only think of really good ones once, and you guys said I had to do more, so I came up with these like 10 minutes ago. All right, so my first one is
because you don't read the Discord, Greg.
I don't give a shit.
I know you don't.
I can play more than 30 songs by one band on guitar, all the way through.
Is this something that you've just... Oh, actually, no, I'm not supposed to ask questions yet, am I? Right, go on, sorry. You can play 30 songs from one artist on the guitar. Yeah. Fuck, that's a lot of songs.
I've never completed Vice City Story.
What, stories?
No, the story. My
of the first
Vice City. Yeah,
go on.
And then the last one is Spotify says I listen to more than 12 hours of music a day on average.
That last one's definitely true.
I think the first one's the lie. I don't think you can play more than 30 songs from one artist. I can't even...
I think he thinks he can, but he can't.
Well, if you gave me 5 minutes, I couldn't name 30 songs from my favourite artist. You know, I'd start struggling at like 15.
Okay, what band is it?
Built Spill.
I knew that would be the fucking answer, and that's rubbish.
It's the lie.
You think?
But I'm pretty comfortable that that's the lie, but we'll analyse these a little bit more.
I think Greg thinks he can do 30 songs.
I think the Vice City thing is true, because I think now, as a gamer, I fucking love an immersive story, and I can't put a fucking controller down unless I've finished the story. You know, things like Red Dead and fucking The Witcher and stuff. I gotta play that story. I'm immersed in it. But I think it used to be a thing sort of with older games where you would play stuff like Grand Theft Auto and you would literally just get in it and just immediately just dick around. You wouldn't do anything.
Every game I think of is a cheat. Then go shoot some civilians.
I don't think I ever completed any game before I was like 12.
But that's the point, isn't it?
I'm going to say the first one.
I think the first one's the lie.
Okay. You've never completed Vice City.
I don't think he has, no. I think that's true. You don't complete games like that as a kid, do you? Greg did. Did he?
He used to play Metal Gear Solid.
How old would he have been when Vice City came out?
8.
Yeah.
He'd have completed a story game at 8.
No, it would have been later than that.
Oh, shit. Yeah, he could have gone back to it.
The first story game I finished completely.
It wasn't 8.
I can't remember, because like, there's so many shitty games you play
was
as a kid.
2002?
I do remember, I completed Metal Gear Solid.
What do you guys think at home? Which one of these is the lie?
Because I replayed Metal Gear Solid older.
This is a fucking good question. I think it's the first one.
I'm going to stick with the first one as well, yeah.
I think he thinks he can play it, but he can't. So I think all of them are lies.
Yeah, that's the thing. I'm not sure. I reckon that is a lie, but you might be right in that he thinks it's true.
There's no way you can play 30 songs.
I've got all night. You're going to do this one time, right?
And I was like, Greg. He was like, yeah, I'll complete all the way to Stairway to Heaven. Like, fair enough.
Dude, I sat and played the entirety of it.
No.
And then Matt was like, oh, that's a bit shorter. And I was like, no, it's not. I've just been there for 9 minutes playing.
He wasn't there for 9 minutes. He was there for about three
minutes. That's the lie! No, right.
Three minutes. You did a 3 minute Stairway to Heaven. And it wasn't even fast. You missed a lot.
That was a fucking footwell to heaven.
All right, I can
Greg,
play
go to get your guitar.
Shut up! I think the first one's the lie.
First one's the lie. That's both our answer.
You don't
want to give it to us. I think you can play 30 songs, but not 30 songs from one band.
No, that's fucking mad.
It's bullshit. And then you have to name all 30 of them if it is true.
Yeah, fuck, yeah, if you're that confident, mate. And you're going to play them for me after this.
Oh, I should have said that.
He's starting to regret it.
We should have said, what 30 songs is it? That should have been the question.
Name them right now.
Actually,
don't actually do that.
It's actually 29.
You are right, it actually is 29. So that was the lie.
Oh, that was a lie. You can play 29.
No. I can play like 3 albums worth, but I don't know if that's 30. It's probably like 20.
Fair play. That's the thing as well. That's the thing you've got to remember.
I thought that would get Matt out. I probably should have gone for a low number.
But that's the thing though. Half of these can be true, but lies even, sorry. But it's still a real story, but you've just tweaked like one thing in it.
I never completed Vice City.
I don't know, that is cheating a little bit.
I completed San Andreas, but I never completed Vice City.
Fair enough. Okay, did you get that right at home, people?
Right, you guys ready for mine?
Yeah. Have you drunk all 3 of those beers already?
Yeah. He drinks
fucking
like a
fucking lunatic.
I drink so fast.
We're 35 minutes in. You drank 3 beers.
I drink like so quick, and then it slows down.
It doesn't slow down.
You drink like that the whole way through.
We did a live stream last night, yeah?
You drank all of your beer instantly.
There was no beer.
Yeah. Right, okay.
Matt was sat there drowning the spirits the whole time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, it's
Matt's
turn.
This one's a quick round, a quick fire round.
Okay.
One. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a fireman.
I reckon that's true. You must have some insight into that. Go on. We'll talk about it afterwards.
I have used a cock ring on more than one occasion.
That's definitely true.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Number 3. I like chewing wet sponges.
That's true. If the first one's a lie. Man never wanted to help people.
What's the wet sponges thing? Have you seen first-hand evidence?
No, I actually haven't. That's a really weird
I've
one,
never seen you with a sponge.
You don't want it. I'm chewing it.
Well, do you go to the shop and just buy sponges?
No, I don't.
They're not a regular household item.
No. I rip them from the sea.
Okay, the sponges thing is the lie. That's just too weird.
Ask me more questions. You've got more questions. Go.
I reckon you did want to be a fireman when you were a kid.
Why would you want to be a fireman?
Because I reckon he was like, fire, fire, I want to be a fireman.
Because he wanted to be a daredevil. Oh, look at me.
Because when
that's
I was younger,
what I was going to say.
Because when I was younger, there was a show on in the UK called London's Burning. I think it's called London's Burning.
And London's
it used to be on the TV. It was kind of like
The Bill.
The Bill. Mm. But it was like, you know, like The Bill's like,
I feel like I should have a memory of this, but I don't.
I don't remember.
I'm kind of suspicious.
London's Burning. Yeah, and I used to watch it and I was like, ah, whatever.
How young are we talking?
About 10.
Right, okay. I was thinking like really young. I was imagining.
Whatever what?
Must he have a lie?
I have used a cock ring on more than one occasion.
That's true, because the amount of... Because you've told me so many sex stories about yourself, right, over the years. So many. Not one of them has been, oh, I fucked this girl missionary once. It's always some... There's always some mental thing that you do. So I definitely think that's true. You once cut your knees up riding so fast for a blowjob, man. You've definitely used a cock ring.
It was my elbows.
Whatever. Yeah. You're the horniest motherfucker ever. That's definitely. You've definitely used a cock ring.
Can I just point out, it says, I have used a cock ring on more than one occasion, but if I do say that is true, that doesn't mean I've used it on my penis. It just means I've used the cock ring.
Then it's 100% true.
Yeah, I reckon you've used a cock ring outside of the bedroom more than you have in it.
Dude, I used to...
You used to buy them at school and flick them at each other.
Dude, I used to get drunk and then buy one at the pub and then just put it in people's beers and stuff. That was buzzing.
You did. I remember stuff like that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I reckon... that one's true. That we don't have to ask any questions about. That one is true.
Next one. I like chewing wet sponges.
That's got to be the lie. Who the fuck... Choose a wet sponge.
The thing is, it's so specific, but I bet, while doing some Freeskins research, I bet you've seen some obsession where someone does that and you've stolen it. I've never once seen you chewing on a fucking sponge.
It's weird. I don't know.
I'm not obsessed with doing it, but if there's a sponge there and it's wet, I will chew on it. Like it's chewing
How
gum.
Often does that occur in your life?
When I go to the bathroom.
Why is there always a wet sponge in a bathroom?
Because I like chewing wet sponges.
It's a lie. Fuck this. I've had enough.
Yeah, that's the lie.
You guys think?
Yeah.
That's the lie, yeah?
Stupid.
The lie is, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a fireman. So fuck you all.
Did you always want to be a daredevil then?
No, I wanted to be an extremist.
Oh, yeah.
He did, yeah.
That's a story for another time.
All right.
So you chew on wet sponges?
Have you ever done it?
No.
Wow, then don't knock it till you try it.
Sorry, yeah, you're right.
This is fucking
weird. You're
man.
Right, man.
I'm gonna write next podcast. I'm buying some sponges for the boys.
Someone that's never seen us before. Imagine them clicking.
Have you never?
No.
Put a wet sponge in your mouth.
Yeah,
and
I've
it.
Done it. It's just it's not that great.
I mean, I'm not one to fucking have a
the
poppy.
Water just the water just comes straight out.
You
of
know
it.
What
it's
my
boring.
Weird thing is like that? Stickers. I've always got to have... if I see a sticker on any... I did it earlier when you showed me their matches. I was trying to pick the sticker off of it. It's like an impulse. I'm like, I can't help it. You could be talking to me about something so important. If there's a packet with a sticker on it, I'm like...
I
got to take that shit off and put it on my face.
My thing is, I just eat bogeys, mate.
Yeah.
I filmed it so many times. Anyway, Lewis.
Delicable.
You
oh,
are...
Oh, fuck, yeah, right.
Second round, guys, second round.
Second and final round.
I hope that at home... You guys are enjoying this and clicking the like button and playing along with us in the comment section. As many comments as you can do, just spam it. That's fine.
Don't spam it, please.
Also,
also what? Hurry up.
Stop drinking my beer, Lewis. Otherwise, I'm going to make you take me to the...
He's going
to
make you take him to
I
the
I can't
shop.
Take you anywhere now. I've been drinking.
Regardless, he's gonna.
That's
he's
the
gonna,
fun of it.
I can drive it down. I haven't been drinking.
No, I can drive it. I've had
Dude,
four.
You
I've had
are
four
not dry-
sips.
Yeah, but look at your frame. You're not. You're staying here tonight. We're sat for bed for you.
Right. Okay.
Oh my god, it's a fucking.
No, it's not. It's
that's
not.
A book.
It's not.
Don't
those
look at it.
Things.
Stop cheating.
I
stop cheating.
Greg. All right.
Don't let him look at it. Don't let
Lewis,
him look at it.
Lewis, point that at him. He can't read that.
It's not that. It's
no one
that.
Can read that. Exactly.
It's three sentences.
I've got bad vision.
Right, okay. This category is, I kind of couldn't help, I couldn't bring myself to bring up any more suppressed memories about myself that were super embarrassing. So my immediate next thought was, oh, I don't like my own embarrassment, but other people's embarrassment. I love that shit. So I started remembering shit about my little brother. I feel like I'm going to talk about my little...
Is this the one that's... The
head like a bomb. The yeah. bomb man. Bombhead. If you're watching yeah. Bombhead...
Watch out for him. He makes
stop
bombs.
Watching my stuff. Get your own friends. Yeah, yeah, and I'm 5 years older than him, so...
Do you actually call him Bombhead to his face?
Yeah. Not so much anymore. He's kind of grown into his head a bit. But when he was a kid, man, anything he said to me, I'd be like, yeah, well, your fucking head's got an orbit. Anything.
Did you ever, like go through customs and then they look at
him? Come on, Bombhead!
Wait a second, he's got... we need to do an x-ray scan on your head. Make sure it's not a bomb.
Pulls the glove out and just starts like rubbing it, sticking like his finger in his ear. Like,
yeah, just putting the hand in the mouth, having a look.
Like a guy in Ace Ventura, like... Right, okay, fuck. This is all about embarrassing shit about my brother. Okay, right. They're all about holidays as well, places we went. Okay. I once went to the Isle of Wight with my little brother. Was at an amusement park. We climbed all the way to the top of a fairy castle where he proceeded to do the biggest shit I've ever seen. So big, it filled his socks. Right.
I hope that's true.
I once went to Finland with my little brother. Was sledging in the snow. He was only an infant. He hurtled down the hill, flew upside down into a pile of lumber, and my parents thought I'd killed him, and he was dead. Like, dead.
I killed him, and he was dead.
Yeah, like, not, oh god, he's really hurt. Like, they thought I'd murdered my brother.
Bomb.
I once went to Cornwall, and my little brother was sat playing on the beach, and a huge dog came over and took a piss on the side of his bucket hat. Right.
Okay. Your brother doesn't have good luck.
Yeah.
These are all like super young. Like I'm talking. Do you know what's right? I was seven. He was like three.
I think that the dog was like an ex sort of police dog.
Shit flaps.
And it saw a bomb and it's like it must put it out.
He was going like
put out like the sizzling like bit of rope on the top.
He does fry in the sun. So yeah, I'll give you that.
Fuck.
Okay.
These are hard. And
do you want me to go through them again? Quick.
Listen,
fire?
Lewis. There's something I don't think I've ever said on the podcast. Me and Greg, like, obviously, it's so much more harder for us to do this one because me and Greg know each other very well. We've been together like
forever.
Yeah.
And we talk to each other about everything. Yeah. But I want to bring this up. I don't think we've ever brought this up on the podcast. There's one time when Greg was very ill and we were about, he was about seven, I was about nine. We had bunk beds as a kid. Yeah.
Oh God.
Yeah.
I know where this is going.
So like, you know, I'm asleep on the bottom. Greg's on the top. Greg's not feeling very well.
No, I wasn't feeling great.
Why didn't you tell this? Oh no, because I'd have known. I wouldn't have known. He'd have known. Sorry.
I was sleeping. Like this.
Mm.
Head out the bottom of the bunk bed.
Oh, dude.
Greg goes over to the side. He pukes all over my head. I don't wake up. My mum was like, I came in and Greg was puking. He puked all over your face and had to wipe off your face. And was trying to
the
keep
you... The thing is,
spirit.
Right, he must have held his head over the side and puked. It must have hit you in the head and you've gone, oh shit. But you carried on. Like, you must have known his head was there.
I didn't care.
You must have just been like, ah, fuck you.
Wait, like, I remember that. And I remember that it was pretty funny.
Oh, God.
That's the thing about having bunk beds. Like, the worst thing about my childhood was having to share a room with Matt. Because Matt is disruptive and annoying.
I can't. It's not fucking working. I think it's out of charge. Oh, no. I think it's take... I don't know if it, when it goes out of charge, it takes a few fucking presses.
What's wrong with me?
You're disruptive. You're annoying. He used to, like, spit on me and shit. Matt was the
That's
worst.
That's right. You used to puke on him.
Matt, nah. There was this thing we used to do in school. There was a guy... There was a wrestler called Tajiri. And what he used to do is this thing called the Red Mist. And what he used to do is get food colouring in his mouth and then spray it.
Oh, yeah, fruit, citrus polos, right?
We did citrus polos. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I remember that. I hated hated it.
I'm so sorry.
I hated it. You were the subject of that, weren't you? Right, sorry. We need to get back to Two Truths, One Lie. I can't even remember what yours were. Oh, no, it was on me, wasn't it?
Yeah, this is yours.
It was my round. Yeah, right. Do you want me to...
Yeah, so...
Do you want me to rapid fire through again real quick?
It's a dog piss.
I once went to the Isle of Wight, was at an amusement park with my little brother. We climbed up to the top of a fairy castle. He did the biggest shit I've ever seen, and it filled...
In his sock.
It filled his socks. He was only little.
He shit himself.
Yeah.
Yeah, but how did his shit get into socks?
He was tiny, man. He was wearing these little dungarees. He was up there. We got to the top of this fairy castle. We're out the window like, Mom, okay, Dad! So, and he just shit his pants poo, and it went everywhere.
The poo came down here and it was just like, oh, I'm going to open up a sock and get inside
I'm
it.
Telling you, dude, it filled his
sock. Lie.
All right, I once went to Finland, was sledging in the snow with my infant brother who hurtled down a hill and flew upside down into a pile of lumber, and my parents thought I'd killed
now,
him.
I know you've gone skiing there before, so that
I once went to Cornwall and my brother was sat playing on the beach and a huge dog came over and took a piss down the side of his bucket hat.
I feel like when you were younger, it was like Stan and Ike from South Park, you know, the big egg-headed Canadian Ike.
Yeah, that's what he looked like. he had really, really blonde hair as well when he was younger. He used to look like, he looked like Ike.
I'm thinking the poo one's a lie, because I don't think poo goes in socks.
No, poo don't go in socks.
How does poo get into a sock?
Poo goes on the outside of socks.
It covers the outside. But if you open up your sock, you'll have a line where the poo has
I don't know if it
poop
got...
Line.
All right, then.
I've peed my pants.
I don't know
loads
if it got in his socks, but it was all over his socks.
You know, kids, in his socks.
You know, kids.
So
know that when
automatically
kids take
a lie.
When kids take a shit, they get it
sounds,
everywhere.
Sounds like
he's,
a lie.
He's twisting it.
He's twisting it.
It was all over his legs and all over his feet. But there was some in his socks.
So it was liquid.
I think it was just that sort of sludgy sort of baby poo. He must have been
like,
about 3 years old, 4 years old, maybe. 4 years old, max.
Well,
he was tiny.
It sounds like with a bombhead, he's clearly got bad balance issues. So Finland sounds about right. He probably lost his balance and went off into a tree. And I think that an ex-police dog is definitely going to pee on a bomb. So I'm
an ex-police dog is going to pee on a bomb.
You made this up about my possibly made-up story.
So
you made that.
Doesn't even exist.
That's true.
Wait, why is he not in this podcast? We need to get him in.
Guest star.
I could call him.
The foreskin.
I could call him at the end of the podcast.
Yeah. Anyway, that's it, the end. The poo one's got to be a lie.
Poo one's a lie, yeah.
I
agree.
It sounds like it could be true, but...
You're both wrong.
Why?
Do we get another... It doesn't
no,
mean
you've
we
lost,
win,
but you can have a redemption
I don't
guess.
Want another guess.
Pee on the head.
Huh?
Pee on the head.
I don't fucking know, man.
You don't care.
The dog piss or he nearly died. You don't care.
I don't care. If
dog
I get
piss.
It wrong.
Dog piss. Dog piss is made up.
I disagree because he rang me.
What do you mean you did? Oh, right, fair enough.
Greg and Bombhead, like grave, the grave and the bomb.
Like once I invent a story, that's the story. And
he did nearly. We thought he was dead. He was like 2-3 years old, and like they put kids in like the big snow suits, so he just looked like the Michelin Man. He couldn't move.
So, like,
we stuck him in a sledge, and the next thing, there's like a hut at the bottom, and there's all this pile of just lumber.
Mm.
And I just remember seeing this, and like I didn't know, and then I've never heard my mum and dad in that like.
Do you
much
think that's
distress.
How he got a bombhead?
No, show you pictures
of
him.
He whacked it on a lumber and it like.
Nah, bro, before that.
Up.
I think that probably.
I feel bad.
I think
man.
He probably made his head smaller.
I'm sorry, Bombhead.
I love you really, you fucking dickhead.
We call you Dynamite Head for now.
Yeah, I've never heard. My mum and dad literally had to like pick him out by like his feet. His feet
was
were
it
just
like,
stuck
out
in it like that.
Maggie Simpson in that starfish suit that she used to wear.
No, it looked like when Winnie the Pooh got stuck in that hole.
Okay, so I had to go through some things that I don't know if Matt knows or if I've told him. So hopefully Matt doesn't know if any of these are real or not. number one, I spent an entire New Year's laid on the floor.
True.
I wonder what the title of this video is. Brilliant. Go on.
That's true.
When I was at Boomtown, I woke up to my entire tent being hotboxed. And it wasn't just weed. There was some weird shit that people were smoking. It smelled chemically. But I don't actually know what it was.
That's true. That's true. Whatever the last one is the lie.
That one's happened to me.
Next
before.
One is I got chased by police for peeing on a road when cars were coming past.
That's the lie. I think.
What's the first one again?
I spent an entire New Year's on the floor.
That's definitely true. Yeah. So it's between the last
two. You think that's true?
I don't even need to ask you why. You were fucking 14. You got absolutely baked at a friend's.
It wasn't anything to do with alcohol or weed.
Really? Were you like really little and you were having a tantrum?
No, I was a Mandy. And my friend had this fur rug that felt really nice.
No, this is not true. This is not true.
It is. This is 100% true. And I laid on the fur rug the entire night.
I think that's true.
Feeling it.
He has told me about this before, but I don't know if it was on New Year's Day.
If that's the lie, that's bullshit. Like, and that did happen, but it wasn't New Year's. It was New Year's Eve.
That's a good lie. Got to hand it to me.
Ah, fuck, man.
Second one
is at Boomtown. I woke up in my tent and it was Hotbox.
I think that one's not the real one. And I'll tell you why. Because that has happened to me.
Yeah.
So I think you've taken that story from me.
Yeah, but would he risk? Yeah, but would he risk that?
No,
would
but he might not know. Is that? Oh, it's not that Amy Schumer like parallel thinking bullshit.
I know that's happened to you.
It's happened to like everyone.
So,
dude, some geezer was blowing weed in my face. he smoked an entire joint, and he was like this close.
That's what happens when you go out camping with friends and drugs, though.
Oh yeah, dude. When I was 17, I was trying to get into nightclubs. I used to borrow one of my friend's brother's ID and used to charge me for it. But he was one of those guys that would charge you for it. Yeah, like he just like give me a tenner. Well, no. But the thing is, if I got in trouble, it was a risk, wasn't it?
Stingy.
Whatever. I used to borrow his ID, and he was one of those guys that was like always in the woods with his friends camping and having fires. Like, and I used to have to, like, I'd be all dressed up for town, like, I'd have these shoes on and a shirt, and I'd be, like, crawling through the woods in the dark trying to find him, and you just find the fire, these guys, like, yo, here's my ID, man. You'd be like, thanks, and then you'd fucking walk off with my buttoned up Fred and Perry, like, just, and my fucking winkle pickers on, just trudging through the woods.
Winkle pickers?
I didn't wear winkle pickers, I was just thinking of the lamest shoes I could,
dude, winkle
pickers, you know,
sounds like some fucking Rolf Harris shit. Yeah. I'm thinking, second one's not real.
Yeah.
Yes.
You want to ask any questions about the others?
I think we're busted on questions.
I think
we're over.
I'm gonna say that the third one's the lie. What do you think?
Peeing in the road.
Second one, no, I think great.
I don't think you've peed in the road.
Do you want to tell the story of it? It's an interesting story.
Yeah, so, tell a story, yeah.
I was out with my mates.
It was shitting in the road, wasn't it, instead?
No. We should dim the lights for this and have the spotlights
like an interrogation. Fuck's sake.
Why are we going to do that for 600 views?
Good point.
We couldn't get a hold of any weed, so we went and bought loads of Frosty Jacks. We got really drunk.
Good substitute.
We got really, really drunk, and there was like a road, and we just thought it'd be funny to just pee on it. And while cars were coming past,
dude, that's so funny.
when you're like 17 and drunk as fuck, it's funny.
Were you like, ha, gotty?
Oh yeah, do you know what?
I'm just peeing in the road, and then a police car.
I'm so guilty of this.
Then we ran off into the woods.
I'm so guilty of this. It's one of the things I fucking.
Yeah, of course it's true.
It's the first one true.
No, I still don't think it's true. I think it's a lie. They're all true. I reckon you've pissed somewhere with your mates and it was funny. But I don't reckon you got chased by the police for pissing in the road when there were cars coming. I don't reckon you did it. Because the police would have caught you. I bet you were a slow kid.
I don't think chemicals.
Hmm?
I don't think chemicals in the tent.
I'm going to say pissing in the road.
Pissing in the road, chemicals in the tent. You're annoyed that I've won, aren't you? That's what it is.
Matt's right.
Oh, fuck! Yeah. That's not true!
No, I've obviously, I hotboxed the tent while I was there, but I never woke up to it.
I was going to say that.
I never woke up, I hotboxed my own tent and then woke up with it still smoky.
I did think that for a brief second. I thought, nah, Greg's the one who was
still smoky. That's bullshit. What are you doing, fucking...
Yeah, no, but that thing you said about...
That's horrible.
Really? That thing, I think it's because of Coors Banquet. That thing you said about, like, when you're 17 and you're drunk and you think it's funny. Like,
yeah,
I know what you mean.
What happened is the police car came up. And then you could see it was about to turn around, and we were like, oh shit, and we just ran into the woods. It was by, I can say it's Fort Ferrum.
Yeah.
It was near where Asda is. I was just peeing on the road there. Just a nice big old piss.
Naughty.
Nah, I'm so guilty of that, though, and it's something I fucking hate about myself, because I'm like, if I'm driving, like, in town late at night, and I see people dicking around, I'm drunk, and I'm like, you idiots, get out of fucking road, what are you doing?
Yeah, but when you're...
When you're 17, you're drunk, you're climbing on shit, taking your top off,
when we were young, we were just assholes.
I get pissed off with school kids. If there are school kids, like, dicking around on the road, if I'm driving at, like, fucking rush, like...
Dude, you need... To lower your stress level.
I know, man.
You do. You just need to. You need to put yourself.
Weed and antidepressants help, but only to a certain extent.
I'm in the car with you, and you're getting angry, and I'm like, whenever I'm out driving, I get angry. Like,
I tell you what, though, I have got better.
The only person who gets angry, Greg gets angry at when he's driving, is me.
Yeah, dude.
We were out driving
earlier.
You're the shittest sat nav ever.
I was on a straight road, and this guy just—he gets to, like, obviously the T jugs or whatever, and he sees me, and he's like, oh, okay, I'm just gonna get out anyway. I had to slow down from like 40 to like 10 miles an hour because this stupid ass prick.
Dude, I had an argument.
That's the only time I ever get annoyed.
I had an argument with a van driver earlier on today, and it's fucking van drivers think, oh, right. Fucking hell. He had a go at me because he didn't give way to the right on a roundabout.
Oh, man.
He got to the roundabout and I was like, I'm going to keep going. And he carried on in front of me and he's looking at me.
We were driving out in the country earlier. Van drivers don't understand the concept of having my space on my side of the road and their space.
My old man's a typical van driver. Like, when I was 17, I used to go in, like, my mate's cars, and you know what I mean? They'd be ragging it around, and you'd just be sat in the back, like, yeah. If I'm in a van with my dad, fucking hell, I'm never so scared in my life. Just does 90
not
everywhere.
Not scared when you're
like,
in a car with me, motherfucker.
Last one.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, I can hear rain.
I walked in on someone getting a blowjob. It was two guys, and they were both straight.
See, I've been to weird house parties where stuff like that's happened, so I can see that happening.
Have you? Dude, I can't remember a club where people wee on each other.
The sort of characters we used to hang out with, man.
You ever drank Baileys from a shoe?
I've seen weird shit in my life.
I once dressed up as a girl and made a fake MySpace page to try and trick my guy friends.
That's true.
That feels true. That has to be true. But it couldn't.
I think you've told me about something.
I dated my childhood crush years later, and it ended because she was painfully boring.
Bro, there's no way that's true because you wouldn't say it out loud. That one is the lie.
She was so boring.
That's the lie, because I know 100% you would not talk about someone like that.
I don't.
You act like you're a hard bastard, but you're a big fucking teddy bear. There's no way, in case she watched, because I know a lot of people from your past watch this.
Painfully boring girls, man.
Yeah, no, I bet that happened to him. I'm not dismissing that, but there's something in that's a lie, because if it is true, he wouldn't say it on a podcast.
You think?
He knows some of his exes watch. Mm. I know you know that because you tell me about it. So there's no way you'd say that.
No, it was only the time when I shat myself on Asda and I sent her the video saying, do you remember this? And she was like, I don't remember that.
And really?
I'm like, oh fuck, I just reminded you of me shitting my fucking pants.
Anyway,
on Asda.
How you been?
Do you guys want me to go through it again?
Yeah, go through
it
again.
Any more questions quickly?
Go through them again.
Go through them again. We'll shoot some questions.
I walked in on someone getting a blowjob. It was two guys and they were both straight.
Was this like a house party or something?
I just feel like that's true because I've been to weird ass house parties where shit like that's happened, okay? I feel like that's got to be true.
See, the thing is though, I believe that until you said the thing about they're both straight.
No.
Because I don't know, I feel like you'd have told me that before, and I feel like if it was true, again, you wouldn't mention it because...
Don't forget, digging.
Yeah, but people that you know might know who those guys are. Do you know what I mean? There might have been rumours or something. I don't know. They might have... Do you know what I mean? People might be like...
Fucking antifreeze on the roof.
If she's watching this, she knows what's up.
I doubt she's watching it, mate. She was drinking antifreeze.
Okay, so walking in on someone getting a blowjob, it was two guys, and they were both straight. Play along, guys. I once dressed up as a girl and made a MySpace page to try and trick my guy friends. I even sent them messages like, hey.
That's the shit you used to do as a kid.
I dated my childhood crush years later, and it ended because she was painfully boring. And I that's mean so See,
I,
boring.
I feel like I've heard that before, so I think that's true. So but then the MySpace boring. One also sounds true, but the blowjob one also sounds true. I'm having a real struggle.
Nah, no, I
See, I
thought like
the blowjob one might be true, but I don't reckon it was two straight guys. That might be a lie, but I'm still convinced that the last one's a lie because I don't think you'd say that. I don't think you'd admit it live. That's too harsh, man. Like, because there's no way you'd have told her that when you broke up with her. You'd have done the whole, look, it's not you, it's me. There's no way you'd have gone, you're just so fucking boring. There's no way you'd have said that to her. Mm-hmm. Unless I don't know you that well, and you would. But I just don't think you'd say that on a podcast, man. That's the lie. That's what I'm saying.
What do you think, Craig?
If that's true, you're a dick. You're a fucking dick. And I'm sorry, lovely lady, if you're watching. I'm sure you're great.
No, she was painfully boring.
She was.
Well, then, do you know this is true? Are you not?
Come on, guys. Come on, this is the last one.
I'm just going for the blowjob one. Whatever, that's a lie.
The blowjob one's fake. You're thinking
your childhood crush. It's boring.
Greg's right.
Oh man, see, it sounds you're like a something dick.
That, sounds like something that could happen, but it's almost.
I'm gonna
that
go.
Was my mate. If you'd have gave me another guess, I'd definitely guess the fucking. Was it? Did you? I bet you've walked in on someone having a blowjob, but it wasn't two straight guys.
It wasn't two straight guys. No, I have. Walked
We've
in.
All walked in on mates up to shit.
Yeah,
all of us.
Ah man, there's one time, my mate like we were out.
Sometimes I didn't even have to.
We're out at field like drinking. And I was like, oh yeah, we'll come back. And we all came. This was when I was like 17 again, back in like Frosty Jack's days and smoking tons of weed. And so we get
last year.
So we get back to my place, and he brings back this girl.
We get back to my place.
They go upstairs and obviously he's like a virgin and all that. And so we're
how
like,
old were you, 17?
Yeah, and we're all like laughing.
You know about this.
We're all like laughing. Like,
take that pillow away.
We're all like laughing. Like, ah, let's go walk in on him. We go up and we're breaking.
Was
and
he
like,
there?
They're like hiding beneath the sheets. And oh my god! And
was
and,
it like Kevin and Perry go large? Like,
it's in Matt's bedroom, but they're using my sheets. And I was just like. I was just like,
you know he had a role to play in that.
I saw him and I was like, my sheets!
You know that they went up to him and went, Matt, can we fuck in your bed? And he went, oh yeah.
I don't even know what Matt was doing.
Use Greg's sheets.
Dude, you don't even understand Greg for like weeks. People would just talk about it. You'd go, but my sheets!
my sheets!
I had to go wash them.
My sheets!
One is sheet
we,
of
we,
plenty.
We made like a rap about him, and there's a part.
My sheets.
Where, yeah, because we used to make like stupid raps about our friends, and there's a bit in the rap where I'm just like
my sheets. Is there any way you can find that?
Yes.
Yeah, I can show.
We'll
you
show
that.
You please. Afterwards.
My sheets. I want to have it as the outro.
Today. So but, yeah, I'm very sorry, and I will show you.
Good mate of mine got a blowjob in the back of my car while I was giving him a lift. I won't say who.
Man, if my mate did that, I'd be like.
I gave him and his.
I'm a cock!
No, I get you, bro. It's,
breaking suddenly.
It's weird. You realise how you react as a human being to shit when stuff like that happens. Because you, in my head, I'd be like, "What the fuck are you doing? fuck? But I was so shocked. And fucking, I picked him up hammered, and I'm at a red light, and he's like, ha, ha, ha. And he opens the door, starts pissing out the car in the street, which is why I remembered this, because you were talking about pissing in the street. And I'm just sat at a red light, and I'm like, pissing I'm in the middle of a city centre, and I'm like, bro, if some police drive past me right now, like, I'm going to get fucked. And I'm like, bro, get back, put your fucking todger away, and get back in the fucking car. He gets back in like, ha, 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 and he sits down next to his missus. I'm driving about 2 minutes, and she's like, I just hear her go, it's still out. And he's like, huh. And he didn't put his dick away. And I'm looking in the wing mirror, like, in the mirror, like, you're a fucking, you're a bell end. Like, and then I just hear this.
Can I just
And I look back, and he's looking at me in the eyes, like.
Can I just point out? It's. Lewis, can I just point out? You are a good friend for letting him get throated.
Mate, I would not allow that in the back of my car.
No, I'd say that as well.
I'd kick him out.
But, bro.
Ain't allowed that shit.
I was like, what do I do? By the time I'd thought about it, I was like,
Greg's right.
He'd finished.
Like, early breaking.
Yeah.
Why didn't I do that?
Guys.
I love them both, but you're, bro, I don't know if you remember that, and I don't know if I've ever spoken to you about you, but you're a knobhead.
I hope that you played along with us.
Yeah. If you got all of them right, again, you're cheating.
If you got all of them wrong, then...
I think I could play 30 songs.
I want to see everyone playing this in the comments. If you're...
Play this with each other.
Yeah. If you're watching this right now, write some in the comments down below, and then everyone else can guess each other's. Perfect.
I hope you like that. Please one. I'm that. Sure that we can do another one of those in the future. We say that every podcast.
I need a bit more time. I think I might have to go and like speak to my mum. Just like, do you remember any weird shit?
So the next... The problem is, it's very difficult for me and Greg. The next podcast is going to be either crazy body modifications, but I don't understand how that's going to work audibly.
It's going to just kind of be us laughing, isn't
it?
Or
we have to describe it as we see it. Or the craziest things found, the craziest foreign bodies found inside a body.
Why don't we let the people vote? What do you want to hear? Crazy body modifications, things found up an arse, or...
Both. That's both in it. That's the same thing.
Well, I find things
up my arse. I always wanted to be a fucking puppet.
Yeah.
I had this rubber fist inside up, to my,
yeah,
up my
you
arse.
Ever go to, like, get Jim you Henson, ever go to get like a chest x-ray? And then, like,
yeah, all the time.
Doctor comes up to you afterwards and is like, dude, what's this?
What? Oh, right, no.
Do you have stick stuff up your ass? Like, you know, like...
What, and you get a chest x-ray? Like,
he gets
nuts and bolts and...
Is that... I bet that's a fetish. Fucking out. I bet that's a fetish. I bet people... You know, like, how flashers, like, flashing you, they don't actually want to insert themselves into you. They get their thrill from just showing you it. Like, nah, and then they run off. Do you reckon there's people that shove things up themselves just to see the doctor or nurse's reaction when they x-ray themselves?
100%
and like, Yeah, that is a fucking... That
if
is a
you
candle,
see the extremity with which some of these people force things up their anuses, you would be...
extremity.
You would be so shocked. These people...
That was such an articulated sentence.
These people go all out with this stuff. It's incredible. It's awe-inspiring. And in fact...
awe-inspiring. Right, guys. The dedication. Let's... Right. I don't think it was called Fat News.
No.
It was Fat Facts... It was something
news. Yeah, Matt News. How many have you got? Because I literally just remembered we could end it on Porn MD. We haven't done that in a couple of podcasts.
Two.
You got two?
I can do one.
What are we on?
Do two.
Do whatever you want.
Well, you know, we'll do what we normally do and we gauge the length of the first one. And if you need a second one, we add it in. Okay. So, fill the dead air for me really quickly, please, guys.
Yeah, so...
You know what really grinds my gears?
I was counting it up, and it's over 20 songs, but it's not.
That's 40. What you were counting.
Yeah.
Right. Everyone ready?
It's time for the news.
This one is nearly half a month old. Woman loses 10 years of memories after she pooped with excessive force.
Okay.
Right.
Well, so she gave herself like a blood clot and lost.
Yeah, because there's got to be some coincidence. Not coincidence. There's got to be some relation between straining to shit so hard and like.
That must feel pretty good if like you're if like you really fucking wronged her. Because now you go up to her and be like, oh, hey, yeah, things have always been fine between us the last 10 years.
Yeah, you've always given me $6,000 every fucking month. Yeah. Yeah, you've always done that.
Oh, man.
You've always let me come over and use your house for
taking
parties
advantage
and stuff.
Of people
they
with
think
memory
that
issues.
The neurosurgeon think that...
Does it say how old she was? Sorry.
Memory loss, hang on. Her memory loss was caused by constipation problems.
But it must have been something to do... Because what causes memory loss? Like... You've got shit like just growing old, being
brain.
Old.
That's something to do with your brain, isn't it?
Yeah, but there's got to be some there's got to be some relation between her needing a shit really bad.
It's straining. It's
yeah, that's strain. What I'm saying. But what did she do? Did she give herself a fucking aneurysm or something? What did she do?
Maybe.
Do you want me to read some of the thing out?
Is there some sciencey stuff or is it just lady poopy, losy memory?
It's from the world of buzz.com.
Oh, okay. Well, oh, this then, is, yeah. This
and
is
it's just cool. Loads of pictures of Japanese-looking bodies sat on a toilet.
Okay.
Think of a Japanese woman's body
yeah.
in a dress
yeah.
shitting on the toilet. Hey. That's all the pictures are on it.
That's oh, hey, I
you
like
know, that. Well, hey, yeah.
Oh, man. He wants to go...
They don't, they don't okay, shit on toilets, do they? They've got shit in
we're
holes.
Going, you know, we're going...
Is that Japan?
No, not Japan, man. They,
that's
they sit on fucking thrones out there.
Oh,
man.
Yeah, actually, I bet they've got, like, Stephen Hawking toilets.
Did they get
like...
their toilets are literally, like, you... You
guys.
Do a little type on it. It like sprays on your bumhole. But
you type
can,
in which
can,
type of.
No, but you can change like the temperature of the spray that goes up your butthole, and you can have like
everyone,
music that plays when you fart a certain tone. It will play a certain song.
That's yeah, true.
It's crazy.
Now look down here. There's a thing called a donation.
Japanese are aliens, aren't they?
And if you guys donate.
Aliens. I'm not saying in a bad way. I'm saying these guys are
now,
fucking...
You guys need to donate thousands of pounds so that we can go to Japan.
They live in a video game.
No, they don't. They live first in the future and in heaven. They live like kings and gods. Like if you were if you compare our lives to like our like the even just the average life of an English person, it's just like.
Do you know what? I've just had a really.
I'm gonna piss on the street and get a blowjob in the back of
I've
the
had
car.
A really.
You know what I mean? Like,
it's all our stories combined.
Yeah, I've had a really fucking weird thought then as you said that though, because I was just thinking to myself, I wish I had all that. Well, I don't know if I wish I had all that stuff, but it'd be interesting to experience. But if you grow up there and that's kind of the norm to you, why are so many Japanese people tourists? If that was my home, everywhere else would be so boring. Could you imagine being Japanese
it's because things are different.
Yeah, but could
that's
you...
It.
It's like, okay.
Have you ever been on a holiday somewhere that's really dull and shit?
No, but if you grow up...
Dude, we went to this place called Egypt, okay? It was like backwards-ass motherfucker, but they had pyramids.
This excessive force led to an increase in abdominal and intracerebral... pressure, which caused a lack of oxygen flow to her brain, resulting in short-term memory loss.
Fuck
so hell. If you really need a poo, don't push that hard. It will come out in the end. Just leave it. Don't push that hard, because otherwise you will forget the last 10 years of your life.
And you'll get hemorrhoids.
The next news story I have is, you guys all heard of Justin Bieber?
I believe.
I know this. I've heard this.
You heard about Justin Bieber?
I have not.
You know who he is?
I believe so.
You've heard of Justin Bieber. You basically were the Justin Bieber of Westbrook Chance. he
that's the corniest fucking thing. And,
he,
I used to hate it when we had to say that. He's the pretty boy. And I used to have to sit there like, shut up.
You are, though. He.
No, I'm not. Go on.
Has challenged Tom Cruise to an MMA fight, a professional one.
I thought this gay shit was gonna stay in YouTube, man. Why are celebrities doing this now? Like, I fucking hate it so much.
Me too.
I can't.
But Tom Cruise is just gonna laugh it off. Of course he's gonna say no. Who the fuck?
Good,
gonna...
don't
dude.
Yeah,
he's gonna
don't...
have his fucking
Tom Cruise,
Scientology
beams. Yeah, let's think about like Tom Cruise for a second. First off, he's like one of the biggest people in one of the most shadiest organizations on the planet. Number two, he is.
Greg, shut up! Greg,
off. You're gonna get. You're just gonna get.
He's
you're gonna
a
be
multi-millionaire,
dude. You're gonna get black vanned.
Dude, what, okay, Scientology dudes. let me hear you out here, okay? look, okay. I know
nothing to do with me.
I'm not saying that Xenu's didn't come down.
I'm gonna just draw a line in the screen here.
Dude,
I'm,
half of Scientology is gonna be like, who's Xenu?
I'm just saying, look, Xenu probably did come down and put people on volcanoes and nuke them and shit. Whatever crazy hoodoo shit you believe.
Hoodoo.
I don't really care, man. Maybe that's true. Maybe Odin's real. Maybe some Jesus dude.
It's been me who's drinking, not you.
Look, all I'm saying is maybe you're right. But that doesn't excuse you for kidnapping people and killing them and shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
Justin Bieber, you're next. You heard it here from
the source.
They're
going to put you in a basement and starve you.
Please stop doing YouTube and celebrity fights.
The battery,
it's really lame.
The battery is running out. So yes, we're going to end it. I mean, we've done fat news. We've done two truths. We've done the two lies. I don't think we've got much else to... You got a Goonie tune? No, let's not bother.
Oh, no, it's too...
I didn't even remember.
You can end it on a quick Porn MD search if you want.
Yes!
Just do that super quick as we sort of outro it.
Yes.
You guys look. You guys get it up, and I'll do the outro scheme.
Yeah, you do the outro.
And one hell of a model American. Right. Thank you very much for watching, everybody. Please remember...
Interracial piss tubes. Interracial asses tubes. This must be the same guy.
It's the same guy.
Swim caps.
He's having multiple tabs. He's searching for everything. He's having one of them crazy wanks. His wife's out. Like, he's going mad.
Pregnant ass smoothie.
What?
Thank you very much, everybody, for watching. Please remember to like this video. It really, really fucking helps us out. We are also on iTunes and Spotify. If you'd rather...
Pokemon ass.
Yes, we are.
If you would rather listen to us on there so you can, you know, listen while you're at the gym or while you're at work, please go over there. But even if you prefer...
PS4 with a pussy. What? That makes no sense.
There's
one guy who loves gaming that much. He wants to fuck his PlayStation. And I bet there's a video for it.
Slave shit eater. Girls out west having a rim.
Girls out west having a rim.
Vacuum torture tits.
Guys, if... Right in the comments, ones you get.
Rimming daddy compilation.
Oh, God. Do the rest of the shit.
Crying. Uncensored hentai anime gangbang.
Made in Canaries. Public wanker in train.
Group of guys with vibrator.
Overwatch. Check couple's money.
Penis foreskin cutting. Penis foreskin cutting.
Piss swallow. Do the rest of the fucking outro. Please outro the fucking
podcast. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. We love you so much. Yeah, it's donations.
Belly punch girls.
Donations down below. All of
that. You fucking prick. I spilled coffee all over the floor, you fucking douchebag!
What happened? What happened?
Fucking...
What happened?
Oh my god,
I did the spider thing.
For anyone who doesn't know, Matt downloaded an app where you can just scroll and do normal things on your phone, but a spider comes on. And he's definitely afraid of spiders.
Go back for like 2 minutes. I'm looking at the camera like.
Suck, man.
What's up?
You know what my fucking bowels are like, mate.
I didn't want.
Clean up the mess, you fucking prick.
Dude, you know I've got a problem with shitting myself. You fucking put a spider on the screen.
Spider screen.
Alright, guys. Dickhead.
Watch all our other. Podcasts,
yeah,
and like them all.
Even if you don't listen to us on iTunes and Spotify, please just go and give us a follow.
That's
on there.
Why I found this. I'm so sorry,
fucking dick, man. Give me a heart attack.
There's a spider that just goes on the screen.
It's fucking horrible. It's not even like a tarantula. It's like one of them big horrible water spiders. Yeah. I'm all confused now. I'm flustered.
Yeah.
See you later.
Enjoy your life.